Hi, boys and girls. It's Samurai Appliance Repair Man. Thank you. Thank you so much. You're too kind. Today, we're going to talk about dryer venting. You know, dryer venting is one of the most misunderstood aspects of dryers that I have found in my years of experience in battling insolent appliances and in dealing with customers. People don't seem to get that if your dryer vent is bad, meaning lots of back pressure, your dryer is not going to run really good. It's not going to run well at all in some cases. So we're going to look at a dryer vent today, and we're going to look at how we can measure the venting back pressure that's in a dryer vent. And we're going to use a special instrument to do that. This is a dryer vent back pressure tester. It's a nifty little instrument that you can, it's available from Whirlpool Corporation. I've got a link where you can buy it. They're inexpensive, very easy to use, comes with a tube that you unravel, and this tube gets stuck in the dryer with the dryer running on a non-heat cycle. It's got four steps on how to use it. I'll explain it right there. Very simple to operate. And the lights that indicate whether you got a bad dryer vent, borderline, mediocre, or good for all dryers. And we're going to demonstrate here in just a minute using this on a real life service call. So we're going to run the dryer vent back pressure tester on this dryer at the customer's request, even though this looks like and is a UL-approved, AHAM-approved dryer vent. In fact, this is a Whirlpool kit. It's all metal. It's fireproof. Very simple. Comes out with a fixed 90-degree fitting from the back of the dryer up through metal ductwork. This is the expando type. It's not smooth-walled, which would be absolutely ideal, but this is okay. This is acceptable. And it goes out the wall through another 90-degree fitting, and that goes straight out. That's an external wall. So it's a very simple dryer vent. The nice thing with this system, too, is that if to pull the dryer out, you disconnect the vent right here, and the whole dryer then can just be pulled out to service behind there if you needed to do that. So, and the reason we're doing that is even though a vent can look good and appear to be a specification vent and up to spec, it can still be bad in a variety of ways. Lint can still accumulate, particularly in those 90-degree fittings. But an easy way to check it out is to use the dryer vent back pressure tester. And we're going to do that right now. Okay, so we're going to get ready to run the vent airflow tester. First thing you want to do is make sure that your lint filter is reasonably clean. This one, you know, it's got some scuzz on there, but it's reasonably clean because you don't want to produce false results if you're with a dirty lint screen. Wherever your screen is, sometimes they're in the door, sometimes they're up here, you know where your lint filter is. Make sure that's clean before you start. Go into a fluff non-heat cycle. Set it for that. Now, to start the instrument, press the power button. The power indicator will blink red, and it's going to stabilize here in just a few seconds. There, steady green, that means it's ready to run. Now we put the vent tube in the dryer and now with the dryer running on a non-heat cycle, the instrument is scanning, and in just a few more seconds it's going to stabilize on the airflow indication for this dryer. It has stabilized on yellow, and I don't know if it shows up in the camera, but yellow means for this instrument is it's good for gas dryers, but it's poor for electric dryers. So electric dryers, this instrument's saying, require a more open and free-flowing vent, less back pressure. So we're gonna figure out, this is surprising, given the simplicity of the vent that I was showing you just a moment ago, this is a surprising result. And so we're going to then poke around a little bit and find out why are we getting a yellow indication? Why aren't we green? And on the good for all dryers, why isn't this vent giving us a green light? Okay, so here we are at the fitting that goes out to the wall on the dryer vent. I'm going to just pull it right out. And, whoa, looky yonder! Just chock full of lint. So lint has settled down into the fitting here. And maybe it was because at one point the flapper on the outside of the house got stuck closed, creating a back pressure condition, and then the lint settled out there from the wet, the humidity in the dryer exhaust caused it to stick to the inside of the fitting. Number of scenarios where that could have occurred, but at any rate, that represents a significant restriction. We're going to clean that out and check the other parts of the vent. We're going to disconnect it up there, and I'm going to go ahead and do that, reconnect everything, and then we're going to rerun the dryer vent airflow test. All right, so with the vent cleaned out, we're running the test again, and here we go. That's what we want to see. Problem solved. One last thing I wanted to point out about the airflow tester is it comes with a sheet that you can make copies of to leave with the customer, and it gives specific recommendations for causes of poor airflow and solutions. It's a good leave behind, good customer education tool. If you're a professional appliantologist, this should be a standard part of your tool bag. All right, go get them.